Fleury, a little village in the Beaujolais area, but also one of the most famous crew from Beaujolais. Let me introduce you to Céline and Jean-Marc. They are from Maison Aujou, our partner in Beaujolais. Céline is our main contact for business and logistics, and Jean-Marc is the cellar master. How are you, Céline?
I'm doing well, Christian, thank you.
What about you, Jean-Marc?
I'm doing well also, thank you.
So, Céline, can you explain a bit about what is Beaujolais?
Beaujolais extends over 36,000 arcs of vines planted in a 34-mile stretch of land that is between 7 and 9 miles wide, producing 12 different appellations. Beaujolais, Beaujolais Village, and the famous 10 crew.
Okay.
Saint-Amour, Julienas, Chenache, Chéroux, Moulin-Vent, Fleury, Renier, Morgon, Brie, and Côte de Brie.
Wonderful. Today we are with the producer of Robert de Buisson. Robert de Buisson is the name of a very old maison in Beaujolais, producing wine from decades and decades. The range of Robert de Buisson includes four different reference, one Beaujolais and three crew from the Beaujolais. So Jean-Marc, can you explain the difference between those four wines?
Yes.
Beaujolais Village, only 38 villages are allowed to produce Beaujolais Village. Those represent the best terroir of the entire appellation. Brouilly. Brouilly is the most southerly of the Beaujolais cru. It's also the most exuberant. It's the biggest cru in terms of volume and the most extensive. Moulin-Vent, its exceptional quality is attributed to the granite subsoil of the area, which is rich in manganese.
So Jean-Marc, does manganese give this very typical taste of violet and mineral touch,
yes,
at the end?
Yes, it's that, yes.
Okay, what about Morgon?
Morgon is without doubt the most typical of the 10 crew, or the easiest to identify in the tasting.
Okay, and you told me that Morgon has a taste profile which is really very, very close from a Burgundy Pinot Noir.
Yes, yes.
Cool. And Céline, any typical food pairing?
Yes, of course. Gamay is a great red wine to pair with meat and cheese plates, but it's also a perfect wine to drink alone, as an aperitif and with some snacks.
Okay, and do you have typical snacks from Beaujolais?
Yes, we've got lots. For example, pétanque croûte, rosé, saucisson.
You name that rosette.
Ah, yes, rosette.
Yeah, okay, good. Check it out.